stopped. The Ducheneys unveiled their new West Side Story program. Kurt Browning had his best practice in preparation for the start of the men's competition tomorrow, while his clubmate from Edmonton, the new Canadian champion, Michael Slipchuk, had a day of ups and downs. Slipchuk had enjoyed a week of impressive practices until he pulled neck muscles yesterday. The injury was first deemed minor, but even after extensive physio, massage, and even acupuncture, Michael was not fit for practice.
Came in this morning to skate and I was just unable to do anything. It was very tight and I just had no rotation, and it was just I had to get off the ice and just kind of regroup. And I came off and the physio staff here did some massage work on it and loosened it up a little more, and then I came on the next session and things were starting to get back to normal. So I feel 100% better than I did this morning. You know, you work your whole life to get here, and you wanna compete and you wanna skate your best. And I think the thing that's keeping me positive and keep me really ready to go is that I've had a great week of practices. I've been really consistent this week and things have been feeling great.
Elvis Stoiko, sixth at last year's Worlds, has also been great in training, showing no ill effects of a stress fracture of his left foot, which plagued him at the Nationals in Moncton.
Well, I've been using an insert in my skate to relieve the pain, and it's great. I only have a slight bit of pain on the outside of my left foot, and it's nothing that should be a major factor here. I'm skating fine and it doesn't really bother me.
Surprisingly, the healthiest Canadian is Kurt Browning. Back problems, which have plagued him since November, appear to be behind him now. Kurt was razor sharp in practice today as the excitement of the Olympics starts to build.
Well, it's been exciting all week, and actually half the battle is to find time to rest. I was so hyper for the first 3 days, I think I've been sleeping for the last 24 hours. That's part of the key, is to time it right so that when it's your time to skate, you're ready.
He's three-time world champion, but preparing for the most important competition of his life.
Yeah, it's the Olympic Games. There's more people than just figure skating fans watching. And, the whole world is centered on Albertville right now, and I think that's pretty exciting. So, yeah, I think it's more important than worlds.
Original program tomorrow, and all eyes will be on the number one skater in the world.
Chris Cuthbert, interesting to hear Kurt say it's important to be ready. He has a knack of being ready for the big event. I mean, think back to Halifax when he was trying to win his second consecutive world championships. He hadn't been that impressive at the Canadians, fell, cut his knee prior to Halifax. He won, wasn't that impressive prior to Munich. He won at Munich. Wasn't that impressive here in November prior to Lalique. I remember the night he skated for gold. He came out and fell three times in the warm-up, but he won. He's a money skater. I was with him last week. He was very relaxed. He likes the relaxed atmosphere here at these games. No big Olympic village. It's spread out. It's like a world championship, and he feels very relaxed. There's a relaxed atmosphere here in our studio. We'll be back with
tonight. The medals won't be handed out tonight, but there's plenty of pressure in this original program. Up to 12 skaters could qualify for the final flight on Saturday to skate for a medal, and none of them can afford, really, Paul, a mistake.
Well, Chris, there is no room for mistakes tonight. Since the demise of the compulsory school figures, the original program has a whole new meaning. It could be said with a strong performance out here tonight, these men can keep themselves in the hunt for a medal. However, a poor performance ensures that they won't be there when they go for gold on Saturday.
Barb, his back problems are a thing of the past, and Kurt Browning remains the favorite.
Well, we've seen a very different Kurt Browning on practice here this week, a very conscientious, focused Kurt Browning, but he has an incredible short program. If he skates it well, I don't think he can be beat. Elvis Stoiko has been skating really, really well. He feels good. Michael Slipchuk, up until 2 days ago, was skating probably the best I've ever seen him skate, but with the injury, we're not sure how that's going to affect him.
Viktor Petrenko leads the group of challengers, and starting tonight's coverage will be a veteran competing now in his third Olympics, Grzegorz Filipowski of Poland.
Grzegorz Filipowski, Polonia. Poland.
31 skaters from 23 countries, and Grzegorz Filipowski is one of the veterans. He was in the final group in Calgary, finished fifth, and he has made the point that you can make a mistake or two in the long program, but you can't afford to do it here.
Grzegorz will be attempting the triple axel double toe loop combination. And he looked way outside of his center in the jump and just couldn't pull it off.
Spoke in our opening, missing elements in this original program is not going to keep you anywhere in the hunt for a medal. And with those two mistakes, I think Gregor has already taken himself out of the race. Remember that here in the short program, the original program, not only do these men concern themselves with wanting to be in the hunt for a medal, but there's also a cutoff point. Only 24 of these skaters are going to get to skate their long program.
And remember that last year, Vyacheslav Zagorodnyak, who should be in the top 10 at least this year, did not even make the cut last year. He was 22nd in the original program.
American Paul Wiley also had trouble. He finished 20th and was right on the cutoff line in Munich.
Gregor was off all last year with a broken foot, and you have to wonder whether taking the year off, coming back. Europeans was his first competition. This is his second. You have to lose a little bit of your edge.
Barb, when he competes next month in Oakland at the World Championships, it will be his 10th Worlds. Nevertheless, his career has been plagued by nerve problems, and I think we saw another evidence of it here.
Well, in 1989, he had his highest finished. He finished on the podium in third place, and I think since then he hasn't really been able to get back up there. Here's a look at his triple axel attempt, and he's outside of his circle. He just can't hold on to that landing edge. But he does attempt the second jump and lands it.
We're going to look at his attempted triple flip. Goes up nicely, seems tight in the air, but he's actually over-rotated. He doesn't start the exit out of the jump early enough.
Barbara Kozowska is his coach and almost his surrogate mother. They both left Poland together, and he lives with his coach and her husband. And they've also run a small restaurant in Rochester, Minnesota over the years.
One of the things that's probably concerning Gregor's most right now is he's skating very early in a field of over 30 men, and you always run the risk when you skate early in an original program, any program, that you could get forgotten, and that's not something that is easily, you know, can't get over that.
Had a look at the judging panel, and Gene Matthews of Canada is judge number five, and the judges taking their time with Filipowski, who was sixth at Lalique in this arena back in November. And again, there was a problem with nerves, and his technical marks way down, so Filipowski is already in a big hole, and I don't think he's going to be able to come near the fifth place finish he enjoyed in Calgary.
First mark, 4-6, 4-7, 4-6, 4-5, 4-6. 4-5, 4-7.
Judges
four,
pretty
five,
well in total
four,
agreement here. The marks ranging from 4-5 to 4-7. Second set of marks for artistic expression much higher, up to 5-5 from the Japanese judge, but Filipowski in a hole after a disappointing performance in the original program. We'll be back with the European champion Peter Barno when we return to the Olympic ice hall in Albertville. 5-5, 5-5.